Hello everybody and welcome to another video tutorial by Vivio Technologies. Today we are going to be talking about using the Win-Acme client to install a Let's Encrypt certificate on an IIS website. To begin, you just go to the Win-Acme website, which is win-acme.com, and then find the download link for the latest version. Once downloaded, move the .zip file to the location that you want to be able to extract the Win-Acme folder. I've already done that here. So I've got this under the C drive, and then in the WinAcme folder, you can see the executable for wacs.exe. Double click on this, and a command prompt should open. If you do not get a command prompt and instead get a Microsoft Defender prompt, just click on the more info and then click run anyways. Now in here, you can see that there's several options that you can choose, but the grayed-out options mean that you cannot run it, and that is because right now we do not have anything that we can renew because we do not have any certificates set up currently. So we're going to create our first certificate on this server, and we are going to choose the in option to do so because the default setting should work fine. If you need to have more full options for the certificate creation, just type M instead. But for now, we're going to do in. And now it is asking us which site in IIS that we want to use for the certificate. I want to secure the myawesometestsite.com. So you can see right next to myawesometestsite.com, it has the 3 option here. So I'm going to type 3 and then click enter. Now it is asking me which bindings in IIS for this site do I want to secure? Because right now this site has 2 bindings. It has myawesometestsite.com and it has www.myawesometestsite.com. I want to secure both of those, so I'm going to type A. But if you do not want to secure both and instead want to do it based off of a hostname search pattern, you can type P. Now that we've selected which site we want to be able to, or which bindings we want to be able to secure within the site, it's asking us which of the bindings we want to use for the subject of the certificate. I'm just going to type 1 to use the root domain and then click enter. Now it is asking me to confirm my selection, so you just type Y and that will say yes. Now you can see that it is going through the process of using the IIS plugin to issue a SSL certificate. It looks like it's reaching out to Let's Encrypt and downloading the certificate. This is only going to work if you have the website pointing to the server. I do have this website pointing to the server, so it looks like it did in fact work. And it looks like it created the IIS bindings, and it looks like everything has been set up properly. I'm going to go into IIS and just confirm to make sure that everything looks good. So I can click on the site in question, click on bindings, and now I can see that I do have HTTPS bindings here. If I click edit, I can just view the certificate it's using, and I can verify that it looks like it is valid, and the details just show it's Let's Encrypt, and it has the right subject in subject alternative names. So it looks like it did work just fine, and it should automatically renew, but if you need to come in here, you can automatically process the renewals, so you can see that there's options for A, so you could type A and click enter, and then you can run a renewal using the R command. We don't need to do that since we just created the certificate. It's valid for 3 months. Let's Encrypt certificates are typically valid for 3 months, and then usually you want to have those certificates renewed around the second month mark, so that way there's a month period where if you run into any issues you can resolve them. But the renewal should happen automatically based off of the scheduled tasks. So if you come in here and go to the Windows Schedule Task, you should see the WinAcme renew name in here for a scheduled task. This is triggered every single day, and it looks like ours is at 9 a.m. every single day. So it should process the renewals when it gets closer to the time for it to expire. Now, I mentioned earlier that you would need to move the executable to a folder that you plan on keeping it at. the if you do end up moving the executable to a new location, such as you create a new folder, you want to move it to a new folder somewhere, you can, but you need to come in here and you need to change the path for this executable. So you go to the Actions tab here and then edit and then change this path to whatever you wherever you move that executable. If you do not do that, then when it's time for that SSL to expire, it's going to expire and you won't have a valid certificate because the renewal could not complete, because the scheduled task that runs every single day is going to be trying to hit this file, which probably won't exist if you move it. So make sure you come in here and update this path if you do end up moving that executable to a location. And that should complete this video. If you have any questions or need further support, you can contact our team, or you can check our knowledge base. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope it helped.